Fantastic. So I want to assume that you had a chance to share. Anybody would like to just take one of the what did God reveal to you through the scriptures? Don't all speak at once. Sure.
Amazing, because no matter where we are in life, whether it's an up or a down, or how depressed we are, what situation or circumstance we're stuck in, this is an amazing example of how we need to keep our eyes fixed on Jesus and to keep on praising Him, because we never know who's watching and who's listening.
Yeah.
So it was just a reminder to me that God was just like, Natasha, keep praising that someone else is going to be saved by through your circumstance.
Amen. So, adult Joseph was captured by the Taliban in the year 2014. It's pretty recent. And he was taken up into the mountains in the snow, in the cold, freezing cold. And he really, really thought he was going to lose his life this time. And he was just really concerned and identified that even as he was working through an interpreter, he attempted to talk to his captors. And it wasn't until he encountered a 19-year-old soldier of the Taliban that he made a connection. And the 19-year-old wanted to talk. 19-year-old said, you know, I don't know anything else but killing people and getting ransoms. I've never seen my father do anything else but that. And he found another young man there as he was able to connect with them and testify of God's word. And I want to tell you that many times we are captured in sin. We are captured in so many ways that we don't even realize. But as the story goes with Dilip Joseph, one of the Navy SEALs came in, one of the teams came in and was able to save him from his captors. But one of the Navy SEALs was killed in the process. And today, Dilip Joseph tells a story, really just publicizes the story because of this one person who died to save him. And I'm just here to ask you today, because we all know in our hearts that there's this one who's died for us.
Amen.
Are we telling the world like Dilip Joseph is? I just want you to think about that. We have something so awesome. As we connect it back to Paul, here is something that's so powerful. That God used an earthquake to free the captives, to free Paul and Silas. And I must confess to you that no guns were present, didn't need any guns, didn't need anything man-made. God used his own nature to do this. And so I want you to go forward from this point, trusting God. Let us restudy this passage. And if you're interested in studying a little bit more, Courtney has offered to study this chapter just a little bit further as we meet downstairs for our energize. But we have so much to praise God, don't we?
Amen. Amen.
So much to praise God. So let's really praise right now.
Praise Him, praise Him, praise Him.
story. So we have the baskets, and we have kids coming by looking for a full basket with many dollar bills.
Building on the temple.
Thank you. Okay, the story is about Jonah and the whale. Jonah and the whale. It says, long ago, there lived a man named Jonah. One day, God told Jonah to go to the city of Nineveh and tell the wicked people there to stop their evil ways. Jonah was fearful of going to Nineveh because the people that lived there were never nice. They were mean people. Jonah was not looking forward to the dangerous mission God had chosen for him. After thinking about God's request, Jonah decided to pack for the journey to Nineveh. He doubted he could do much to change the people there and thought that if the trip became too frivolous, he could always turn around and go home. Do you ever feel sometimes that God put us in a situation where we don't want to be, but we have to do it because it's God's will telling us to do something? Can you share a story with me? It was much doubt and fear that Jonah started on his journey. Partway there, Jonah came up to a fork in the road, and the road led to Nineveh, and the other road led to Sikho's town of Joppa. So this is a little picture of where he's heading. Jonah gave in to his fear and decided to take the road to Joppa. So he was standing in a position where he didn't know which way to go, and somehow the Holy Spirit told him to go to Joppa. So from there, he hoped to find a boat that would take him far away from God and the dangerous city of Nineveh. One ticket, please, to anywhere.